कर्णेभिश्शुणियाम देवाः भद्रं पश्येमाक्षभिर्यजत्राः स्थिरैरङ्गैस्तुष्टुवागुं स्वस्तनूभिः व्यशेम देवहितं यदायुः स्वस्ति न इन्द्रो वृद्धश्रवाः स्वस्ति नः पूषा विश्ववेदाः स्वस्ति नस्तार्क्ष्यो अरिष्टनेमिः स्वस्ति नो बृहस्पतिर्दधातु ओम शांति 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 ही मे इट बी ऑस्पिशियसनेस दैट वी सी दैट वी हियर दैट वी डू मे दैट ऑस्पिशियसनेस गवर्न एवरीथिंग बिकॉज दैट इज ही मे द मास्टर इन हिज वेरीड मैनिफेस्टेशंस बी वेल एंड कीप अस वेल सो दैट वी कैन प्ले आवर रोल्स in the banner fit. Surrendered in totality to his will and grace. Om. Yanti devavratan devan. Pitrin yanti pitruvrataha. So those who want to be, you know, united with their ancestors, pitrin yanti pitruvrataha. So that vratam you are doing, your tapas you are doing. Bhutani yanti bhutejya. Okay, those who want to become the bhutaganas, they become that by their tapas. And finally he says beautifully, yanti madhyajinopi mam. Those who do tapas to attain me, they attain me. Yanti madhyajinopi mam. We should do the tapas to reach him. First is ananya bhakti. Then is seeing to it that every action of yours is dedicated to him. Then do tapas to reach it. Because he is the only source of true joy. You cannot get true joy in this world. It is not possible. Because any joy that comes, which is world-based, will have its end. It will have to finish. Then again the seeking starts. Then that will finish. You may get it. Again it will finish. Then again the seeking starts. You will get that whatever joy you want. Again it will finish. Again you will start seeking. At the end of it, you'll feel tired. Then you will turn to him. Yanti madhyajinopi mam. And he says, samoham sarva bhuteshu name dveshosti na priyah ye bhajanti tu mam bhaktya mai teteshu chapyaham. He says, for me, but although I'm telling all this, for me, everybody is equal. Everybody, every being, I look at equally. But like a matter of fact, those who think of me, those who have bhakti to me, come to me, become me. Because it is a matter of fact. Not because I prefer them. I don't have any preference. Everybody is the same for me. But because they are dedicated to me, they come to me, they merge in me. They become me, I become them. Apiche sudhuracharo bhajate mam ananya bhak sadhureva samantavyaha samyak vyavasito hi saha. Such a beautiful verse. Apiche sudhuracharo. He can be the worst of people. He can be the worst of people. Bhajate mam ananya bhak. But if he turns to me, sadhureva samantavyaha, you must consider him to be a sadhu. Samyak vyavasito hi saha. So, this, you know, there are such beautiful examples of apparently people going completely on the wrong path, turning and becoming complete devotees of the master. Why am I telling this? Why is Geetacharya telling? I'm telling this because Geetacharya is saying it. Why is Geetacharya telling this? Because there is hope for everybody. There is hope for everybody. He says, Kshipram Bhavati Dharmatma, because such a person who was actually completely on the wrong path, the moment he turned to me, Kshipram, Kshipram is very fast. Bhavati Dharmatma, he becomes a Dharmatma. Shashwat Shanti Nigachati, and he goes for Shashwata Shanti. He goes and gets permanent peace. Kaunteya, Pratijanihi. Just understand, O Kaunteya, O son of Kunti, O Arjuna, understand. Name Bhakta Pranashyati. Such a beautiful verse. Name Bhakta Pranashyati. My Bhakta can never fall, can never get Nasha. I'm always there to protect them. I will see to it that they become Dharmatma. I will see to it that they become Dharmatma and they become closer and closer to me and merge into me in the final stage. I will see to it. Name Bhakta Pranashyati. So there are so many beautiful stories for this. Kshipram Bhavati Dharmatma. And before this also, see, I was just thinking, this is such a beautiful verse. Apichet Suduracharo. Avan kettavana irkatom. Umba kettavana irkatom. Doesn't matter even if he's the worst of people. When he turns to me, I will take care of them. Immediately they will become good. They will become Dharmatma. There is such a beautiful example of Vibhishana coming and falling at Rama's feet. When Vibhishana comes and falls at Rama's feet, we've done this beautiful varnam. Rama, Rama, Jaya, Raghurama. Sharanagati endru varum bhaktarukku abhayam endra varam nee kodupai. And we do the sanchari of Vibhishana Sharanagati. When Vibhishana comes to fall at Rama's feet, all the monkeys are very worried because he is Ravana's brother. Look at the lineage. He is Ravana's brother. So Sugriva finally gives counsel to Rama and says, don't believe him. This could very well be the ploy of Ravana. Don't believe him. What if we all go for a toss only because this man has been given Sharanagati by you? Don't you see? He is the brother of our enemy. Suduracharo. He has been, what he has done, he is a Rakshasa. All said and done, he is a Rakshasa. Forget it, he is not even a human being, he is a Rakshasa. He is not even a man. Bhajate mam ananya bhak, but he has come to you. Don't give him Sharanagati under any circumstance. If you give him Sharanagati, you know you are asking for trouble, he says. And Rama's mission statement comes at that time. The entire Ramayana's mission statement comes at that time. He says, Sakrideva prapannaya tavasmi iti cha yachate abhayam sarvabhutebhyo dadami etat pratam mamai. He says, apichet suduracharu. Itacharya says, bhajate imam ananya bhak. He can be durachara. Sakradeva prapannaya, Rama is saying, he's come and he's done prapatti to me. He has fallen at my feet. And what has he said? Tavasmi, I am yours, he says. Tavasmi iti cha yachate. My mission statement, abhayam sarvabhutebhyo dadami. I will give abhaya to everyone who does sharanagati to me. That is my vrata. Dadami etad vratam mama. And then he tells Sugriva, what if he is Vibhishana? What if he is Ravana himself? If this had been Ravana himself also, I would have let him go. I would have given him Sharanagati. Apichet suduracharo bhajate mam ananya bhak. Sadhureva samantavyaha. You must consider him to be a sadhu. Samyak vyavasitoti saha. Kshipram bhavati dharmatma. Fast, he'll become a very, very fantastically advanced, ready to receive jnana soul. Kshipram bhavati dharmatma. Shashwat chantim nigachati. Ready to receive jnana, which is the only shashwata shanti. Kaunteya pratijanihi name bhakta pranashyati. There are many stories of how beautiful this moment of change has happened beautiful moment of change has happened in Tulsidas's case, when he was going with the karma towards the woman of his attention and love. Suddenly she gives him the Upadesha and he becomes the Tulsidas we know. Vilva Mangal. Purandara Dasa. Before, with Lobha, he is approaching the world. Then, with Bhakti, he approaches Krishna. That one moment of change is enough. That one moment, Kshipram Bhavati Dharmatma. That when Bhagavan decides to take over, they can be the worst of people. Immediately, 1 second, they will change completely. So, if Bhagavan is so kind to such lobbies and such kamis and such people, can we not be a little indulgent toward these small wrongdoers? Little bit patience let us have. When Bhagavan takes over, he will take over. No, it is his job, not ours. We are not here to set the world right. We are here to play our roles well and go on talking about the right path. That's all. Not as advice, but living the right path. They can see. They can see, right? They can see and then they will change automatically. So let us be a little non-judgmental. Bhagavan doesn't judge anybody. Samam sarveshu bhuteshu. So let us not be judgmental. Let us accept everybody as Bhagavan would. Right? Bhagavan would accept everybody. There is this beautiful story of this sinner who came to Bhagavan Ramana Maharshi. Terrible sinner he was. Comes there, completely disturbed state of mind. And he comes there. And Bhagavan says, I am ready to take whatever you give. Before you give me your sins, I'm going to ask you for something else. What can I give you? I don't have anything except my bag of sins, he says. Bhagavan says, no. Give me your merit. Merit? I don't have any merit, he says. You just say you surrender your merit to me, he says. He says, yes, I will surrender my merit to you, he says. And immediately he feels an upliftment. Then he says, now give me your papa. He says, it is too much. Why do you worry? Give it to me, he says. And the moment Bhagavan accepts that, there is only that beautiful state of equanimity. Bhagavan will take whatever we are ready to give him. He will take. He will make all the right equations. He will see to it that his bhakta reaches him. Finally, he says in the 9th chapter, Manmanabhava Madbhakto Madhyaji Mam Namaskuru Mame Vaishyasi Yukpaivam Atmanam Matparayanaha. Manmanabhava, be always doing manana on me. Madbhakto, be devoted to me. Madhyaji, do offerings in my name for me. Mam Namaskuru, do pranam to me. Mame Vaishyasi, you will attain me. You will have yukti with me. In a later chapter, he says, Mame Vaishyasi Satyam Te Pratijane Priyosi. Maybe we will come to that much later. Because he gives the promise of complete union with the undivided self, with Bhagavan himself. He allows us the experience of undivided, unalloyed bliss only because of his grace. Because he accepts us as we are. Whoever we are, whatever we are, however we are, he loves us. He loves us unconditionally. Let us try to bring a little bit of that love into our lives and love everyone unconditionally and make everyone have the experience of true love.